You're watching Czar Films Variety Channel. Hi there, and welcome to today's video. Today we're going to show you how to clone your original drive to an SSD drive. We did install a 250 gigabyte SSD drive into this Acer Aspire E576. I'll put a link below to that video on how to install the M.2 SSD drive. Okay, our SSD is installed and you need to initialize it or format it. So if that's not been done, you can go into the files section, open up this PC, and all the way over you can see that it is all set. So if you wanted to format it, you would right click and then hit format, and it will erase anything that's on there. So we formatted it. Okay, so once you've gotten into disk management, you want to go ahead and right click your disk there, and if you are given the option to initialize, then go ahead and do that, initialize the disk. And you want to initialize it to the same style as your original disk. So right click this one, go to properties, go to volumes, and it will show that it's GPT. And if you go here to properties, volumes, it is GTP. So we are ready to clone the system. So we open up the Easeus TODO program. So we get into the Easeus TODO program. You go open and click that top button, then it'll bring us down to system clone. I'm going to go ahead and click that. And it's going to show already our source disk, which is already here. And it's looking for the target disk. So this is the target disk, but you want to go down to advanced options and optimize for SSD. Okay, go ahead there. This is your target disk. Then you want to click proceed. So now we'll go ahead and proceed, and the speed at which the cloning will occur is based on your computer, hardware and such. So here we go, we are initializing clone. All right, there we are. So we're just cruising right along. We're about halfway through. And yeah, we're about halfway through, about 6 minutes elapsed time. About 55%. So it's probably gonna take 10, 15 minutes. So the system was set to shut down after cloning, and now we're rebooting it just to make sure that the primary operating system on the original drive is still working. Then we're gonna go ahead and show you how to shift the SSD to be the boot drive. So we're going to check the boot drive and change it if we need to. We're going to push power and F2 to enter BIOS. And apparently it's not letting me. I think the SD drive is already aligned in front because it's booting in like 10 to 15 seconds. So I think Easeus software automatically aligned the SSD. Normally you got to go in the BIOS to change the boot order. Okay, so we went and checked, we opened up our settings and went into storage, and we can see that the software actually made the SSD drive the boot drive by using system clone. So it is booting off the 250 gigabyte drive, and it's showing the terabyte drive is still got 930 gigs. So if that didn't happen for you, you need to start it up, hit F2, get into the BIOS menu, and then flip the order and make your SSD the first in line. You'll be able to do that. Then I think you'll hit F6 to move up the SSD, and then hit F10 to back out. But for some reason, the Easeus software did it for me. And we can see right here that this is the primary drive, and it's booting in like 10 seconds. We'll try that again. So it worked. And that is how you clone your drive using Easeus to do. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Please click like, please subscribe, please comment below. Thank you so much for watching.